In this video, we'll be looking at the different kinds of claims we encounter in categorical logic. What is categorical logic? It's a formal system where we use a particular kind of claim, or particular kinds of claims, to show relationships between members of two different categories. Now, the good news is there are only four different kinds of categorical claims in the categorical logic we're looking at, so it's not too complicated just yet. Conveniently, they are named after the first four vowels, and they're also in an order that makes sense. So these claim forms are called A, E, I, and O. All right, so pretty simple so far. Now, there are two aspects to the relationship expressed by each claim form. The first aspect we're going to look at is whether the claim is about all of the members of a category or whether it's about just some of those members. Claims about all members of the subject term, that's the first term in the claim, they're called universal claims. And the first two kinds of claims, A and E, these are universal claims. So let's mark those as universal. A claims can take the form all S are P. Now, an example of this might be all cats are orange things. Notice that categorical claims don't have to be true. For instance, there are cats that aren't orange. And that's just like any other claim that you'd encounter. A claim is just a statement that can be true or false. So don't think that any claim you encounter is going to be true. or you'll have a hard time in the world. E claims take the form no S. RP. And S and P, again, are variables. They're the things that can change. They are the categories. Generally, these are known as terms, and the first one is the subject term, and the second one is the predicate term. Okay. An example of this might be, just to be silly, no potatoes are hairy animals. This one's probably true. Unless we're in an old 50s B movie or something. Then they might be hairy animals. So you can see how A claims and E claims are about the entire category. In the first one, it's all of the cats with no exception. There's not going to be a cat, if this claim is true, there's not going to be a cat that's not an orange thing. All of the cats are an orange thing. Okay. Same thing with the E claim. No potatoes are hairy animals. There's not going to be a single potato that is a hairy animal. Okay, so it's about the whole class, not just part of the class. So, I and O claims are different in that respect. They're what we might call partial claims. So as you might have guessed, they're not about the whole class. They're about just part of the class and how part of the first class, part of that first category, relates to the second category. So let's take a look at that with the first one. An I claim takes the form some SRP. So we might come up with an example that perhaps this applies to you. Some students are crammers. Okay, so for this kind of claim to be true, all we need is that one member of this first class, of the subject class, represented by our subject term, students in this case, we just need one of those things to also be a member of the second class, the class of crammers. Now I say one even though the word is some. Usually in everyday English, some means that there's at least two. But for us, it really means at least one. So, in categorical logic, some means at least, at least one. Okay, so all you need is a single individual that's both a student and a crammer, and then this statement, some students are crammers, will be true in categorical logic. Okay, so let's take a look at the last kind of claim, an O claim. This is also a partial claim, so it will start with some, meaning at least one. Some S are not P. Some S are not P. So, this is very similar to an I claim, except you've got this negative part here. Some are not, so there's a difference between them. We're saying that at least one member of the subject category is not also a member of the predicate category. So, we might have as an example that some dinners are not filling meals. Another example that's probably true. So keep in mind that with any partial claim like some students are crammers, that doesn't automatically make a claim that in everyday life, if someone were to say this, it doesn't make the universal claim true, the corresponding universal claim, or it doesn't make it false. It doesn't make it true or false. So just because someone says some students are crammers, if we assume that that's true, in everyday life you might say that if you think that some students are not crammers, but we're not going to assume that that's the case here. It could be the case that all students are crammers, and then the I claim, some students are crammers, would still be true. Okay. But it could also be the case that it's not true that all students are crammers, but some students still are crammers. So what I'm saying is that just because the I claim is true, that doesn't tell us whether the corresponding A claim is true or false. It could be that all students are crammers, it could be that not all students are crammers. We just don't know, so we don't want to assume that. It's not implied by this. But we do know that if some students are crammers, that the corresponding E claim, no students are crammers, is false. Okay, so there are certain implications that we know based on this.